In this example, we'll write a program to calculate the area of a triangle. In case we don't remember, we should look that up from some reference source, in this case the internet. The area of a triangle is half the base times the height. And we find our formula here, 1/2 base times height. We can create an IPO chart. Our inputs would be base and height. Our output would be area. And the process would be area equals 1/2 the base times the height. Let's look at how this would look in C++. We need to declare all our variables that showed up in our IPO. So we're going to go ahead and double base, height, and area. Okay. Remember, double is for floating point numbers. So if we expect a decimal point, we would want to use double. If we didn't, we could use int or integer. Okay, the next step, our input, we need an input base. Remember, we need a user-friendly output, so we use a cout statement to put a literal string on the screen to prompt the user, enter the base of the triangle, and then we cin or get input from the keyboard base. So that's our first input. Our next input is for height, so again, we have a pair of cout and cin statements. So user-friendly prompt and the actual input statement to get input from the keyboard into height. We have our assignment statement here, area equals 1/2 base times height. Now we have a little problem here in C++. Our variable names don't match, so if we tried to compile this right now, we're going to have a syntax error. So we actually have to use the same variable names. So it would have to be base and height. And we also need an operator. In math class, if we see B and H together, that implies multiplication. But in C++, we have to explicitly everywhere say multiply. So even here, we need a multiplication symbol. Okay. So it basically 1 divided by 2 times base times height would be the equivalent of our formula that we looked up. Okay. And then our output statement, the area of a triangle is area, okay, and with an inline. Now we still have one problem here that I'm going to show you in our statement here, mainly dealing with this 1/2. But let's test our program. We'll compile it and run it. And I'm going to use some simple inputs. So I'll pick, okay, so we'll pick some easy numbers, 2 for the base, and also 2 for the height. And as you can see, we have a problem here. It's telling us the area of the triangle is 0. Okay, now let's go back to this. Even though 1 and 2, 1 divided by 2 normally we would think is like 0.5 decimal, but you have to be aware of something in C++, because the data type for 1 and the data type for 2, even though they're constants, are integers, you get an integer result. So 1 divided by 2 is 0.5, but the result being an integer, you chop off the decimal part, so it turns out to be 0. Okay, I know that's a little bit different, maybe, but that's how integer division works. So to change that, we're going to change one of the two numbers into a non-integer or floating point number just by simply changing, adding the 0.0 on the end. So divided by 2.0. This becomes a floating point number, or a real number, and by the rules of promotion, when we have an integer divided by a floating point, we convert everything to floating point. Okay, and so if we run this again, okay, we should get 2, 2, and 2. So 2 times 2 is 4 divided by 2. Okay, good. We get the right answer. The triangle, the area of the triangle is 2. So just something to be aware of with integer division. You have to be careful of that in the future. Okay, and a simple fix is just to put the 0.0. We don't change the value. We just change the data type of that constant.